pages 37 to 50 in your agenda papers, and I'm going to hand over again to officers to do a presentation.
Thank you, Chair. The application is land opposite 1050 Phil Ferguson's in Gildon Way, and the application is for a temporary pop-up shop for a period of 2 years. So this application is before you tonight, members, because there's been a number of objections to the application, and they're detailed in your report, which runs contrary to the Office of Recommendation of Approval. We consider that the temporary shop will provide a much needed facility within Gildon Park and actually provide a stock-up and provision of this important service until the permanent facility is built out by the consortium, which is a requirement of their Section 106 requirement. So this is the application site here, these are 10 to 15 Field Fair. This is the main entrance into Gildon Park. So phase one reserve house was granted in 2015, and that includes provision of 300 square metre commercial retail floor space with a development that totals 1,100 dwellings. So this is the site plan. As I said, it's located centrally within the wider site, say it's the proposal is for a user shipping container which is painted dark grey with a fully glazed front elevation to be wheelchair accessible. The container measures 12 metres by 3.1 with a height of 2.6 metres. The intention is to operate between 9 a.m. and 9 p.m. and to be operated by 3 members of staff. This is from the local plan, so the site is within the green finger, and obviously PL5, your local plan, relates to development within such locations. And just some photographs of the site, so you can just see the area, and in effect the container just would be dropped onto this hard standing in this location here. This is a layout. You can see 2 parking spaces to the front and the elevations. So the principle is as detailed in your report, I say policy PL5 is relevant, and that does allow for development of infrastructure within the Green Fingers where it is reasonably required. We believe that the proposal therefore complies with that policy. It's small scale development also, which is again a requirement of that policy. It is only proposed for a 2 year period, and that allows the consortium to deliver the permanent facility on the site. And it's really required to avoid further unavoidable delays to actually provide this valuable community facility. So the principal development is therefore acceptable, subject to the proposed conditions to require its removal at the end of the 2 year period. The design and appearance is considered acceptable. It is, by its very nature, a relatively utilitarian appearance. It is a shipping container, there's no getting away from that, but obviously the glazed elevation and the cladding will actually improve its visual appearance, and say for a period of 2 years it's considered acceptable. It's a quick solution to actually be able to get something on site for the benefit of the wider residents. In terms of highways, the proposal has those 2 parking spaces provided. We consider that's acceptable given that the shop would be within walking distance of the vast majority of residents on the estate and provides basically day-to-day retail needs rather than bulk shopping trips. It's also got a further 8 side parking spaces, which is an increase over what the parking standards require, which would be 4 spaces for this development. In terms of residential amenity, the hours will be restricted from 9 till 9 Monday to Sunday, with deliveries restricted to 8 and 10 Monday to Saturday. There's a litter and refuse management plan required, and we believe that in terms of the impact on the residential amenity, it's acceptable within those hours. And it is a very small scale development that isn't going to generate significant vehicular activity or comings and goings. The recommendation, Chair, therefore, is to approve Commission's subject to the conditions as listed in the report. Thank you.
Thank you very much. There are no speakers from the public, either against or from the agent and applicant. So I'll go straight to questions and clarifications from members of the committee. Councillor Souter.
Thank you, Chair. If this gets approved tonight, when will the old cabin or container be installed?
We don't have a definitive date, but our understanding is that it will be done quickly. And the hard standing is there ready to put it on. It is literally a case of being able to lift it onto the site and getting it done. So I think it will be a quick win solution.
Thank you very much. Any other councillors? Councillor Lepon?
Yes, thank you, Chair. There have been quite a few controversies regarding the delivery of infrastructure on this site, and what sanctions could be imposed in the event that this is not removed within 2 years and the delivery doesn't take place?
And you?
Certainly, Chair. So there is a condition seeking its removal after 2 years. Obviously, if that wasn't removed or they hadn't come back to us seeking an extension of time, then obviously it would leave us with potential enforcement action if we so wish. But what we would, obviously, we will stay in dialogue as we're having regular communication with the consortium about delivery of infrastructure on the site as a whole. Because what we don't want to happen is if there is a slight delay to the permanent facility, we wouldn't want there to be a gap in the provision of providing this retail space. That might be there is an extension, we don't know, but our understanding is that they will be able to deliver the permanent facility and therefore this will be able to be replaced.
Okay, thank you for that. Obviously, putting in the permanent facility will require a separate planning. I mean, is there, and we were talking about 2 years, is there any time frame for that planning to be submitted?
My recollection is that the permanent facility is to be delivered by the end of 2025. I know that they're working through processes at the moment, consortium. As I say, we are having regular discussions with them, and these are matters that are on the table. And we're looking to assist and facilitate discussion with them to kind of get these delivered for the benefits of the wider park.
One final question. Who is actually going to operate this shop? Is it a consortium or is it going to be franchised to a group, co-op, or some chain?
We don't have those details, and that would be outside of the planning function in terms of who would operate it, but I'm sure they're having discussions.
Thank you.
Other councillors that may wish to comment? Or question? No questions, so we'll move to comments then. We'll move to the debate. Anyone want to kick us off?
Thank you, Chair. I mean, the people in the area need to have some facility. I mean, you know that some people said they had Tesco's, etc., down the road, but they need something on that site. But we also need, it's been pointed out, the developer to come in and rectify the length of time that it hasn't been going on. So this pop-up is a remedy that can be used by the residents as a very good facility that they need, and with a 2 year span, let's hope the developer does pick up on this and puts the appropriate permanent fixtures in, because this is going on and it shouldn't be. Thank you, Chair.
Thank you, Councillor Hamilton.
Thank you, Chair. I suppose I, being a bit of an optimist, had hoped that the permanent facility would arrive earlier so that there would be no need for this temporary arrangement to be in situ for the 2 years. However, it's beginning to look as if the timeline is actually quite tight if we're assuming at this stage that the permanent facility won't be delivered until 2 years. 2 years from now is a remarkable coincidence. But it certainly is the case that while this isn't likely to be the prettiest building in the world, even with the cladding that we've heard about, it is badly needed. It seems to be convenient certainly overdue. And I note that the 2 years are to start from this evening if we agree on the application. So not from the arrival of this structure, but from the wording is the date of this permission.
Yes, certainly, Chair, thank you. In terms of it wouldn't start from tonight, it starts on the date that we formally issued the decision notice. So that might be a day or two down the line. So the 2 years kicks in from that date rather than your recommendation tonight.
I think Councillor Morrison's comment is, though, that it's not, they can deliver a union in March next year and say it's 2 years from there. It's 2 years from the publication of any decision.
That's correct, Chair. It's 2 years from the date of the decision notice rather than the date of the actual delivery on site.
Okay, any other councillors want to debate? No? I'll give my view. I agree with Councillor Morrison what you say about looking at the people from the local area that are saying they're desperately in need of something. And actually, I think we should be able to shop local. We should be able to not just jump in our cars and go to the supermarket. We should be able to walk around the corner to a small shop and get a couple of bits if we need a loaf of bread or a pint of milk or whatever. So I'm sure there will be some residents that won't be happy, and it's not the most attractive of buildings, but it is a stopgap solution and is holding the developers to account to make sure that they deliver the infrastructure that they promised to residents. So there being no other comments being made, I'm going to put that to the committee and ask all those in favour. Again, another unanimous decision.